Hello friends, good evening. Welcome back to our channel ALP Talks. This is your Lakshmipathy. So today here we are going to discuss power current protection, because this is one of the very very much a useful topic in all the electrical system, because wherever current flows in the network, the current to be monitored properly, whether it is as per the designed value or not, because if it crosses the limit of the equipment or limit of the system, then there can be a lot of risk. It can be fire risk mainly. So there are those things we have to take. Sometimes it may blast also. So we have to take care all the current related things, mainly the power. Under current it doesn't matter anything, because it is under the capacity only. Power current is the main thing. So mainly at the utilization side, where the current capacity is very high, where for example furnace or any distribution loads, and there are some motor loads, there are some cases where there is chance for drawing more current from the system. So in those cases, generally this power current protection plays a major role. So let's discuss about it. I can say this is an introductory like that. So in future videos about each topic, I will discuss in a separate video also in a detailed manner. In this I am trying to give some overview, what are the different schemes we have, so that you also can get some better understanding. Yeah, if you are watching this video for the first time, please subscribe to this channel so that I will get notifications whenever I am uploading the videos. Yeah, if you like the video, just like it and comment it, so that I can make better videos in the future as per your feedback. So let's talk about it. So there are certain things we have to take care in the power current relay. For example, power current means say 100 amp is the normal current, there may be flowing 120 amp. Then how much time that 120 amp is flowing? 120 amp for 1 second it may be okay, sometimes for 2 second it is okay. If it is first if it is pertaining to maybe more than 10 seconds, then it is not okay, right? That's what I am going to say. Now there are some time related characteristics, now time and current characteristics. I think now you understand it. 1 second is okay, 2 second is okay, but 10 second is not okay, 20 second is not okay. So there is time also dependent. So that is the time and current characteristics. You have different varieties here, you can see it here. There are different terminology, technical terminology we will use in the industry. So definite time over current relay, instantaneous over current relay, inverse time over current relay, inverse definite time over current relay, very inverse time over current relay, extremely inverse time over current relay, some special characteristics also there, and some time characteristics, and some electromechanical relays also we are going to see some of the slides on that. So each relay is there, they have their own device, their own application. So based on the application, everything matters. So we have to take care here. So this is the characteristic of, this is very important. I'm just going to explain it what it is. So here on x axis you have actuating quantity, and y axis you have operating quantity. For example, if operating time. So this is the peak actuating quantity, that is the value, how much current. For example, it is very high amp, say instead of 100 it is coming 200, 300 or 400. If it very high amp means it needs to be disconnected very quickly, right? Otherwise some problem will happen. That is the thing here. So within very less time it will be disconnected, operating time, the relay will operate within very less time. If current amplitude is very less, then no problem, right? It can withstand for more time also. Yeah. So here you have definite time characteristics and inverse time characteristics. So we will discuss more things in the coming slides. Yeah, this is some of the equations what we will use in the industry for the equipment. For example, whatever the relay we have, for the relay how much time we have to give the settings. So this is some of the formulas. Here I use the current, the n value you will see in the coming slides. Based on each application there is some different n values. Yeah, this is the similar graph. You can see this for 1 and 10, and in between you have different timings. So here you can see operating time, and this is the value, how many times the current. So you have different inverse time, we will say IDMT, very inverse time and extremely inverse time. These are the three different relays you have. This is the graph. Yeah, these are some of the methods I told. We have a same formula, the exponent whatever it is there, that varies from case to case. For example, as per British standards, if it is a 0.02, then it is ID empty. If it is 1, very inverse. If it is 2, then extremely inverse. Yeah, of course, the numerator is a little bit varies based on the application. So there are some current settings. For you, there are some parameters, plug setting multiplier, we will say PSM, and the operating time is on y-axis, so how much time it is required. So in the relay, we have to set the plug PSM for the proper operation, how much you need. Here you can see secondary current, whatever the current is, the secondary current, and then relay current setting, how much you are going to set it. So this is one of the thing, and you have one more thing here. The secondary current is nothing but the false current, and here you can see relay current setting into CT ratio, you can multiply with that, so that PSM you can set accordingly. Yeah, so this is the setting here you can see. So current in ampere, 5 amp, 10 amp, 20 amp, 50 amp, you can set PSM here. There are different PSM available. So when relay will operate, you can see from this graph, from this table. Here you have some examples. For example, so this is the one of the plug setting multiplier, 2, 4, 5, 8, 10, 20. So the operating time in seconds, you have different timings here. If it is a plug setting multiplier, 20 means 20 times we can say. So it needs to be operated very quickly. That is the first thing you can see here. So the relay has a 150% plug setting multiplier, and time setting it is a 0.4. We are using CT 400 by 5 amp. And so here we are going to determine the operating time of relay for the fault current of 6000 amp. If 6000 amp current is flowing in the circuit, then how much time we have to, I mean, how much within time the relay has to operate? That is the problem here. So let's see the thing here. So this is the characteristic curve for that. So here we are going to solve that one. So 150% of CT is 400 by 5, right? So the ratio is nothing but 80 amp. So whatever the CT secondary is, that is 5 amp. So 150% of 5 amp is nothing but 1.5 into 5. So 7.5 ampere will come. So here you can see PSM plug setting multiplier is nothing but whatever the fault current you have, 6000 divided by that 7.5 into CT ratio 80. So you got 10. So it should be 10 plug setting multiplier. So you know that from the table for the 10, you can, in this table for the plug setting multiplier of 10, you can see 2.8 is the operating time. So within 2.8 seconds the relay is going to operate. So simply you have let's see. So the operating time TMS for 0.4 second will be 2.8 into 0.4, so it will be 1.12 second. Yeah, this is the one of the basic problem, so that you can get some actual reality how it will be. And there are some certain schemes. For example, you have a very big line, say it is almost 1 kilometer line, for example. So the current, whatever the current is there at the end of, say ABC is there, A is starting, C is finishing, B is at the middle. So if the fault is happening at the end of the line, at the for example 1 kilometer, then it is the 0.5 second. For example, the relay is operating at 0.5 second. It is at B, then 1 second. It is at A, then 1.5 second. So there is some grading, time graded system. We can say this is one sort of backup protection. If C is operating, if C is not operating, then after 1 second, B is going to operate. If B and C both are not going to operate due to some issue or something, then after 1.5 second, A is going to operate. This is one type of backup protection, so that is better. Otherwise, if nothing is going to operate, then the system is going to explode, right? So this is one of the better technique you have. Here you have current grading. If 80% of current is there, then A is going to operate. If it is some extra, B is going to operate. If it is extra, C is going to operate. But here you can see in this slide, all are combined, combination of time and current grading. You can see it here, A, B, C. So A is a low current, B is a high current, C is very high current, for example. So if it is very high current, means it needs to be operated very quickly, right? That's what this graph says. Yeah. So here you have another problem. For example, here you have one line. So two relays we have placed, A and B, and the CT is also there. Then one fault is there at some other location. Say the fault current is around 16,000 ampere. 16,000 ampere. So we used 800 by 5 amp CT, and plug setting 125% and 0.2 second at B we given. So circuit breaker will take 0.2 seconds to clear the fault. and there is some error in the relay also, for example 0.15 second. So plug setting for A is 200 amp, then what is TMS? I mean, how much time it will take for A to operate? This is one of the question here. So we know that 16,000 amp in the fault current, so CT ratio 800/5. So what is the secondary current? Is nothing but whatever the main current 16,000 amp is there, that 16,000 amp divided by CT ratio, it is 100 amp. So there is a 100 amp now. So 125% of 5, so that will give you 6.25. So simply divide 100 by 6.25, the plug setting will be 16. So for the plug setting multiplier of 16, TMS of 1, so it will be 2.5 seconds. Similarly, for B it is a 0.2, so 0.2 into 2.5 will be 0.5 seconds. So the discrimination time is nothing but time for breaker at B, how much time the breaker will take. For example, the breaker is taking 0.2 second at the B. So twice the relay error, whatever the relay error is there, we have to multiply that time. So 0.5 second is there now. This is because one relay may run rapidly while second relay runs slowly. Moreover, the relay A does not reset until the breaker interrupted the false current. So we have to take some extra discrimination time. So we are considering 1 second finally. So the secondary current in A is nothing but 100 amp. 200% of A is nothing but 10 amp is there. So 100 by 10 is 10. So plug setting is 10. For 10 of plug setting, we have 3 seconds here. So actual time required is 1 second, right? So 1 by 3 is nothing but 0.33. So you have to set time setting multiplier of TMS of 0.33 in the relay. So that is one of the example here. So this is another example. For example, you have one transformer of 20 MVA. So it is 25% overloaded. For example, 11 kV bus, it is some circuit breaker is there. Other circuit breakers supply outgoing feeders. The transformer circuit breaker is equipped with 1000 by 5 amp CT and the feeder circuit breaker with 500 by 5 CT and all CTs induction type overcurrent relay. So here you have 125% plug setting and 0.4 time setting. For example, if a 3 phase fault of current 7500 amp flows from the transformer to one of the feeder, find the operating time of the feeder. They are asking operating time. Here you know that secondary current is nothing but 75 ampere. So relay setting 125% of 5 amp is 6.25. So PSM will be 12. So for 12, PSM of 12 and TMS of 1, it is a 2.8 second. As we already have the table, since TMS of 0.4 is 0.4, so 0.4 into 2.8 will give 1.12. Here is the transformer overload current for that 125%. Here you have 1312 ampere. So secondary current will be simply the ratio will multiply 6.56 ampere. So the plug setting can be 6.56 by PS into 5. So here you will get finally 131%. The plug setting is nothing but 131%. So the plug setting is restricted to a standard values. We don't have 131, we have only 150 nearest value. So taking 150 is good one. So secondary fault current 7500 is nothing but 37.5 amp. So relay setting should be 7.5 amp. So this is one of the problem. So PSM for that will be secondary fault current by relay current. So it will be PSM will be 5. For that PSM, you will have a TMS of 1 is 4.7 second. So here also, operating time and discrimination time generally you have to consider. So that 1.12 plus 0.5 is 1.62. So if you divide 1.62 by 4.7, you will get a multiplier, time multiplying setting 0.345. This thing we are going to use. Similarly, this is also another example. I am not going to the many details here. You can go through this. This is a self-explanatory. Here you have two relays here. So in this case also, you have a TMS of 0.34. So there are some mechanical relays we are using. If for example, sometimes current can flow from one direction to other direction, sometimes power flow from in reverse direction. These things generally will happen, for example, when from generator to it is giving supply to the grid. Sometimes when generator has some issue, then it will take power from the grid. So in that case, reverse flow will be there. So then in some cases we should use a reverse power or a directional relay so that we should block it, reverse flow we can block it. So the for example here you have voltage and current. These are two combination will give the directional relay for us. So we are using shading coil here and some compensating circuit also. So we have a trip command also here. So this is the this is for directional relay. This is the phase diagram V and I, and current is lagging by 90 degree, and I1 is the secondary current, whatever you have here, compensating circuit current I2. So this is another one, induction cup type directional relay. Only thing is it is looped. I mean we can say there are two different phases in this case, we can say. So only one thing, whatever it is there, it is simply drawn connected for other phase also, I mean opposite phase also. Yeah, one is current and another one is voltage. This is one of the method we are using. So here you have a reverse and negative torque and positive torque also. So the circuit connect, circuit diagram will be like this, voltage coil, whatever the load is there in series with some current coil will be there. Yeah, so this is some other phasor diagrams, we can say vector diagrams. If it have A is for 30 degree connection and B is for a 90 degree connection. So this is one of the directional power current relay. So this is a combination of both power current unit and similarly directional unit. We know that for directional unit V and I is required. For power current we need I. So I and same current will flow in both the circuits. So the protection of parallel feeders. There are some cases where we have parallel feeders also. So two feeders are there. So for this is the scheme. So when fault is at F, for both B and D is going to operate. Sometimes ring main unit also there. For the ring main unit, say for example fault F1 is there, then the C dash and D dash is going to operate. So sometimes fault F2 is there, then D and A dash is going to operate. So this is one of the system. This is for ring main systems. This is another example with figures. So the earth fault and phase fault protection relay. For example, ABC is the phases, and this is the star connected. Say for example, this is the transformer. So whatever the neutral terminal is there, this is brought out, and we have connected one CT there. So if CT carries some current it means some neutral current is flowing. It is nothing but there is some problem with the phases, right? Then only current will flow in the CT. So if the current exceeds certain value, then whatever the relay is there, then we will say earth fault protection scheme, the relay will activate it. So here you can see in the circuit diagram format, simply the relay is going to give some command and trip command. So the circuit breaker or whatever it is there, it is going to operate the circuit. I mean, it's going to open the circuit so that everything from there, it is protected. Yeah, you can see here instead of a CT at here, so this is one big CT. All the three phases are going to flow through this are rooted inside the CT. So instead of a neutral formation, we also can do like this. This is also one of the good way. Yeah, so you can see combined earth fault and phase fault protection in this CT. So whatever CTs you have, we just connected it, and all CTs only with three relays we are going to achieve this. Four relay is not required. So this is another scheme. We are having only three relays here. So directional earth fault relay. Sometimes direction also matters in the earth fault relay. For example, whatever the current flows in the relay, we have one coil, right? That coil current we are going to give to some directional earth fault relay. So the current through this is again the combination of all the currents here. So this is one of the directional earth fault relay. Another figure, you can see it here. So you have residual current, I residual here. Similarly, you can see it here, voltage residual, V residual here. But we are using here some potential transformer in this case. Yeah. So this is another setup here. Whenever power current, we are going to give this connection to the power current relay. This is to earth fault relay. Yeah. So the setup will be, the equation will be like this, whatever we seen earlier, K by I power n minus 1. So instantaneous power current relay, generally we will have input current and finally output is trip signal. Based on the input current, whatever they will be given to the transformer, some filter will be there, some level detector will be there, some amplifier will be there for amplifying that level detector, some comparators, everything will be there. So whatever the output comes, that output we are going going to give to some trips as a trip signal to the circuit breaker. Yeah, so this is also same thing, but here definite time over current relay, there are some different processes. So here you have a level detector, potentiometer also, that is the only difference. So the equation is like this, RC log V minus VT. So if it is a inverse time over current relay, only thing, there will be one feedback in the internally, one place to another place, remaining all things are same. So here you can see, this is the I and this is the input and this is trip signal. Here you have another, this is directional, right? So we need I and V, both terminals. So we are getting V also, so that we can decide it. Yeah, so there are numerical relays also in the system. For example, microprocessor based, some digital DSP based, some FPGA based, some artificial neural network, ANN based, numerical relays also there. These things we will use in some of the advanced cases. Yeah, first time I am introducing some of the questions here. You can see these questions. So what are the various types of overcurrent relays? So I explained some plug setting problem. Some problems I kept it here. So around 11 questions are there. So I think these questions will give some good understanding to you if you are going to attempt it. So try to post your answers in the comments. So answers already available here. Try to keep in a descriptive format. So it is it will give some good understanding to you. If you have any questions or comments or anything, then please comment in comment section so that I can make things clear. Yeah, if you are watching this video for the first time, then don't forget to subscribe to this channel so that whenever I am uploading videos, you will get notification. Yeah, thank you guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching. So if you want to be a part of a member on this channel, then please comment your details or topic, then I will contact you so that you can present your ideas on this channel. Thank you. Thanks a lot. We will meet in next video. Bye. Shalom.